So now we discuss about equivalence relation and the equivalence relation with partition. And after that we can discuss about the few problems based on the equivalence relation and partial ordering. And so what is the equivalence relation? In the equivalence relation we can say a relation R on a non-empty set S, we can follow the three properties of the equivalence relation. Generally the equivalence relation is used to classification of object in way they are alike. So the equivalence relation property have three property. One is the reflexive, another is the symmetric, and third is the transitive. So these three property we have hold, so we can say that relation is belong to the equivalence relation. And as we have discussed already, reflexive relation says A is a member of set S and A comma A is a member of R, A relate to A. So we can say that type of relation is called as a reflexive relation. In symmetric relation we can say A comma B is a member of set S, A relate to B, then B also relate to A, then we can say it is a symmetric relation. And the third relation is the transitivity relation, in which A, B, C is a member of S, A relate B and B relate C, then A relate C. So that we can say also A comma B is a member of R and B comma C is also member of R, then A comma C is a member of R. So these three properties we can hold, then we can say that type of relation is called as equivalence relation. Now generally the equivalence relation is used in classification of the object in which they agree to alike. So generally that equivalence relation concept is used in theory of computation and compiler construction. So now the next point is equivalence relation with partition. So we can find the equivalence relation along with the partition. We can say a partition P on non-empty set S under the collection of all the subset we can treat it as a A of I. So what we can do, we can use the two main properties in equivalence relation with the partition. The partition property is that, first property we can say for A is a member of set S. S is a set, A is an element. A is an element of set S, belong to some A of I. A of I is nothing but a subset. And second property, if AI not equal to AJ, then AI intersection AJ equal to null set or equal to phi. So these two property we can follow with the help of partition. So equivalence relation with the partition we can say, so R is an equivalence relation on set S and each A in set S. So let we can denote in the square of A, that is denote A related to relation R. So that is nothing but the square of A, which is X such that A comma X is a member of R. So the one formula you have to remember this thing. So this is the A related to A, which is X such that A comma X is a member of R. So now here the A is called as a equivalence class A in set S. So similarly, any we can take B is a member of A is also represent the equivalence class. In that case, the collection of equivalence class Fraction of equivalence class of element of S or set S under relation R, it represents S less R equal to a square of A such that A is a member of S. And that S less R, it is called as a quotient set. That is called as a QUOTIENT, quotient set. So that quotient set has the three properties. So the thing is that with equivalence relation with the partition, we can find the quotient set, and quotient set have the three properties. If A element related to R equal to B, then we can say A comma B is a member of R. Second, if element of A not related to element of B, we can say A comma B is not A, A and B are disjoint. Or we can say A, element of A and B are disjoint. And the third property that holds, that is, for each A in S, for each A in set S, A is a member of A related to R. So that is the equivalence relation with the partition. So now we solve the few problems based on the equivalence relation and partition. So first we can solve how to check whether the relation is equivalence relation, and second we can perform the equivalence relation with the partition, that is induced by the R. So we can take a few problems in which we can more clarify about the concept. So the first problem we can write: if the set A, it can consist of element 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and now the relation equal to x comma y such that x plus y equal to 5, and you want to check whether it is an equivalence relation or not. So what we can do, the element of set is total 1 to 5, we can take the relation equal to, we can put the value of x equal to 1 and value of y equal to 4, the summation becomes 5. So that is, one pair is 1 comma 4, when we can take the value of x is 2. So here the x value and y value. So we can take 1 and 4, the summation becomes 5. We can take 2 and 3, again sum become 5. Now the third value we can take 4 comma 1, again the sum become 5, and next value we can take 3 comma 2, the sum become 5. So this, we have to only take the 4 ordered pair as a relation from value 1 to 5, because the equation says relation x plus y must be equal to 5. Now we can check whether it is an equivalence relation or not. So the equivalence relation have three properties. First is the reflexive, another is the symmetric, third is the transitivity. So here the reflexive property says A relate to A, but here no one relate to 1 and 2 relate to 2, 3 relate to 3. So here A not relate to A, A comma A not a member of R. So we can say it is a not reflexive. It is a not reflexive. Second, it is a symmetric. So in symmetric, say A relate B, then B relate A. A comma B is a member of R, as well as B comma A also member of R. So here we can take 1 comma 4 is also consists 4 comma 1, 2 comma 3 consists and also 3 comma 2 consists. So it is a symmetric relation. And third, it is again non-transitive. Non-transitivity, because 1 comma 4 is a member of R, 4 comma 1 is a member of R, but 1 comma 1 is not a member of R. So it is not an equivalence relation. So equivalence relation only when it is a reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So it is not reflexive, not transitive, so we can say it is not equivalence relation. So that is the problem in which we can find whether the relation is equivalence or not. Now, the next problem, another problem which we can discuss, which is a R relation on the following set That is set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and relation is given in the form 1, 1, 1, 5, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 6, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 6, 4, 4, 5, 1, 5, 5, 6, 2, 6, 3, and 6, 6. So find the partition, A induced by R, or find the equivalence class or R, or we can also write the equivalence class of R. So how to solve this type of problem? So first step is, we can solve this type of problem, that is equivalence class with partition. So step 1 is, the element 1 is related to, so here we know the partition set says element of A related, which is X, such that A comma X is a member of R, and we can follow the same concept here, and we can find the element 1 is related to 1 is related to 1, 1 is related to 5, and 5 is related to 1. So the 1 related to R is only 2 element 1 comma 5. So now we can pick up, that is step 1. In step 2 we can pick up element 2, which are not already related in the previous partition. So we can take the partition 2. 2 is related to what type of element? 2 is related to 2. Then now it is related to 3. It is related to 6. And 2 related to 3. And now, so the elements which are related to 2, it is 2. Then it is 3. Then it is 6. 2, 6, 3, 2. So it is the 3 elements which are related. That is called the element 2 related to the other partition. Now step 3, we can take, pick up the element which are not already related. So 1 is 2, 3. We can select the element 4, which are not still related or still partition. So as we know the two properties of the partition, AI not equal to AJ, then AI intersection AJ equal to null. That is the party of the, that is the property of the partition. So we can pick up the element 4, and which is related to only 4 and nothing element. So 4 is related to 4. So we can say all the element we have to cover, and that is 5 is related to 5, we can cover 6, 6 and this is. So now the partition A induced by R equal to 1, 5, 2, 3, 6 and 4. So total number of element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the partition where they can follow the property of the AI intersection is equal to null. So no element of the set have the same value. So that is the equivalent class of the R, or partition induced by the R. So now few more problems we can discuss based on the equivalence class and relation. So now the problem third we have taken as a problem in the form of graph. There is a, we can given a graph A, B, C, D are the vertices, and here we can give the graph. It is a self loop. It is a graph 1, and the another graph is A, B and C. It is contains self loop, and now the structure is like that. So we want to check whether both are the directed graph. So that we have to discuss in the later class, but before we can start this problem based on the relation, we can say graph equal to V, E, where V is the set of vertices and E is the set of edges. In a directed graph, we can give the direction, either we can move from A to C or we can move from C to D. So that is the distinct ordered pair, but in undirected graph, there is no direction, we can move from either A to C or we can also move from C to A. So in a directed graph, we can also use the two property. One is the self loop, another is the parallel edge. So that we have to detail discuss in the case of graph theory and problem. Here in this, based on this following figure, you can check whether the both graph is partial order or it is an equivalence relation. So how to solve this problem? We can solve, this is a graph 1, it is a graph G2. What we can do? We can first find the relation. So here, the relation equal to A to B, it is called A comma B. Second is B to A, the arrow moves towards the A. So that's why it is B comma A. Then A comma C, C comma D, and B comma D, and C comma C. So this is the way of the relation, and the another relation in the graph G2 is called, it is a self loop A comma A, then it is A comma C, C comma B, B comma A, B comma B, and C comma C. Now we can find out whether that relation we can generate based on this graph. Now we can find whether it is equivalence or whether it is a partial order. So first we know the equivalence relation has certain property. In equivalence relation, we can say it is a symmetric, reflexive, and transitive. So we can say this is a property of the equivalence relation. When it is a partial ordering, the property is reflexive, anti-symmetric, and transitive. So we can check based on this whether it is a graph is equivalence or partial ordering. So what we can do, we can first take this relation, we can check it is no A related to A. So it is a not, R is not reflexive. Why it is not reflexive? Because reflexive property says, in reflexive we can say A related to A and A comma A is a member of R. So here in this case, A not related to A and A comma A is not a member of R. So R is, we can say, it is symmetric, A related to B, B related to A. It is symmetric. But A related to C, C related to A, it is not symmetric. But only for two ordered pair it is symmetric, other than it is not symmetric. So R is not symmetric, A related B, but not B related to C. Now R is transitive, it is also A related to B, B related to B, but no, it is also not transitive. So we can say it is not reflexive, not symmetric, and non transitive. That's why it is not neither equivalence and nor partial ordering. Now we can check this another graph. It is the A comma A, B comma B, and C comma C. It indicates it is a reflexive. So first, it is a reflexive because A relate to A and A comma A is a member of R. Now second property is the symmetric. A comma C, then C comma A also relate? No. So we can say it is a not symmetric. And third, it is also not transitive because A relate B, B relate C, but A not relate to C. So here we can say it is also neither equivalence and nor partial ordering. So we can solve based on the graph we can find the relation, and relation after relation we can know the property of the equivalence relation is symmetric, reflexive and transitive. Partial order property is reflective, antisymmetric and transitive. They are not follow these three properties, that's why it is neither equivalence nor partial ordering. Both the graph. Now the next problem. The next problem is the set A equal to A, B, C and relation is given A, 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 B, B, C and C, C. We can find the reflexive closure, symmetric closure and transitive closure. So, what is the reflexive closure? Reflexive of R equal to R union lambda or delta A. So in this delta A says like that equal to A comma A such that A relate to A, or A comma A is a member of R, such that A comma A is a member of R. So here A comma A is existing, B comma B not existing and C comma C is there. So what we can do, we can simply add B comma B. So what will be the result? The R union B comma B, it is find the reflexive closure. So the reflexive closure value is equal to A comma B, B comma C comma C and B comma B. Similarly, we can find the symmetric closure. So symmetric of R is nothing but R union R inverse. So symmetric of closure we can find R union R inverse. So R inverse means A comma A inverse is same A comma A. Now A comma B inverse is B comma B. So it is B comma A. B comma C inverse is C comma B. So now the value become, the resultant value R union, this is generate the reflexive symmetric closure. Now, so that is equivalent result is A comma B, B comma C, B comma A and C comma B. Now we can find the transitive closure. So transitive closure is nothing but if there is a total number of element is 3. So we can find R union R square union R cube. So what is the R square? R square is nothing but R composite R and R cube equal to R composite R, or which is equal to R square composite R. So how to find this element? We can just take, this is the set A, B and C. Now here we can take A, B, C and this is the R composite R, A, B, C. Here the relation is A to B, next A to B, next B to C, next C to C. Again A to A, A to B, B to C and C to C. This is the R composite R relation. Now we can again, we can observe that with the help of relation the value is A comma A and A comma B, A comma C and B comma C and C comma C. So only one element we have to additional income, that is A comma C. Again we can find the composite operation, again composite of R, which is find the R cube, let's say A, B and C, A to B, then B to C and C to C, that is relation. So in that relation we can find the R cube, which is nothing but that also generate the same value, which is this one A comma A, A comma B, A comma C, B comma C and C comma C. Now we can find the union R union R square union R cube, which is nothing but the value which we generate A comma B, A comma C, B comma C and C comma C. So that's the way in which we can find out the closure of transitive, reflexive and symmetric closure. So now, next problem we can discuss. And that is, if the A equal to, problem number 5, A equal to 1, 2 and B equal to x, y, z is given and C equal to 3, 4. We can find A cross B cross C in the tree diagram with the help of tree diagram. So all order are in triples. We can say A is a member of A, B is a member of set of B, C is a member of set of C. So n of A element is 2, n of B element number of element is 3, in n of C total number of element is 2. So n of A cross B cross C, which is equal to 2 into 3 into 2, which is n of A dot n of B dot n of C, that is equal to 12. So total number of combinations which we can find, which is 12. In the help of tree diagram, what we can do, we can take even point in which first the A element 1 and 2, or in we can draw in a specific way, it is the 1, it is the 2. Now 1 again come in the form of x, y and z. Again 2 come in the form of x, y and z. Now in x they can contain 2 elements, 1 is the 3, another is the 4. Y again contain 2 elements, 3 and 4. So that way in which we can draw a tree. Again 3 and 4. Now total number of element 1 comma x comma 3. So here 1 comma x comma 3 is a one ordered pair. Another pair is 1x4. Here 1y3, 1y4. Here 1z3, 1z4. That is 2x3, 2x4. Similarly 2y3 and 2y4, and here the 2z3 and 2z4. So total number of combination is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that is the 12, and 12 order of pair we can generate based on the graph. So what we can do here, we can take first one element y with 3, second with 4, third 1y3, 1y4, then 1z3, 1z4, then 2x3, 2x4, 2y3, 2y4, and similarly we can all the ordered pair we can generate based on this problem. So now the next problem is the problem number 6, which is the given is A is a set of railway tracks and B and C are the sets of, we can say sets of cities in Rajasthan. So we can find that A cross B cross C. Here we should know A is a member of A, small b is a member of B, and small c is a member of set of C element. So here we can find A cross B cross C equal to A comma, because B and C are the cities of the Rajasthan, A is a railway tracks. So here we can say such that A is a member of A, B is a member of B, and C is a member of C. So that is the sort of way in which we can solve the A cross B cross C. Now the another problem is that find the number of relation. Find the number of relation from A equal to ABC and to B equal to 1, 2. Here in this case, there is a A to D relation, total number of element is 3 into 2 equal to 6 element. So number of subset, how many number of subset they can be generate? So n number of subset is nothing but 2 to the power n, which is nothing but equal to 2 to the power 6. So we can say 64 subsets from A cross B. So it is a 64 subset of A cross B from A to B, from the relation A to B. Now another problem is that a relation of positive integer is defined. So the next problem is relation on positive integer is defined r equal to x plus 3y equal to 12. X plus 3y equal to 12, and we can find the ordered pair. What we can find? Ordered pair, we can find the domain, and we can find the range. So first thing is that relation of positive integer. That means the value of natural number, we can start from 1, 2, 3 up to n. And r equal to given x plus 3y equal to 12. So what the value we can take up to n, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the relation is like that. When we can put the value of y equal to 1, it is equal to 3. And 3 plus 9 equal to 12. So here 9 comma 1 is the 1 pair. Because when you can 1 multiply by 3, the value of y is 1. And here we can take 9. So 9 plus 3 equal to nothing but 12. Another pair, we can take the value of y equal to 2. So it is 6. So 6 comma 2. Next, when we can put the value of y equal to 3. So 3 into 3, 9 plus 3. So the value is 3 comma 3. So only the 3 pair we can generate when the summation of x plus 3y equal to 12. So this is the ordered pair we can generate it. Now that is called the ordered pair. Now the domain is, in the relation R, the domain is the first element of the ordered pair. So first element is only 9, 6 and 3. So these are the domain. Domain equal to first element 9 comma 6 comma 3. And what is the range? Range is nothing but the second element of the relation R, ordered pair. So here the relation is 1 comma 2 comma 3. So that is the, we can find the domain, range and ordered pair. So now the next one we can find out also the R inverse. Relation inverse is nothing but it is 1 comma 9, 2 comma 6, 3 comma 3. Now we can find the R composite R, the composition of the R composite R. So it is the relation we can find. We can just take the element total 1, 2, 3, 6, 9. Here we can take 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 1, 2, 3, 6, 9. It is the relation R, that is the R composite R. So the relation is 9 to 1, that is 9 to 1, 6 to 2, 6 to 2 and 3 to 3. Now again 9 to 1, 6 to 2 and 3 to 3. So as you observe that only the relation they are connecting this 3 to this 3. So only the composition is, the value should be generated as a 3 comma 3. So that is the way in which they can given the only simple equation, and you want to find what is the ordered pair, inverse, domain, range and the composition of the operation. So that's the type of problems we can discuss based on the relation, and the equivalence relation, partial ordering relation, composition of the relation, and that type of problem we can discuss part of the relation. Thank you.